The short story I'm doing is The Post by Anwar Khan. It is about a girl who remains unnamed for the entire story, taking the place of a mannequin. The main character of the story remains unnamed for the entire story. She is said to look like a dignified and sophisticated person. In the short story, the narrator says, but now she was a grown young woman, a college student, smart, sophisticated, urban. Even the most daring boys at college got cold feet walking with her. This also shows how she presented herself to others. She was always meant to present herself in a formal manner, and anything less would be a disgrace to her family. Now to talk about her actions and behaviors. In the story, the unnamed girl does a peculiar thing and takes the place of a mannequin in the storefront where everyone can see her through the glass. She acts as if she is just trying to have fun. She can only do these types of stunts when no one she knows is around, because in front of them she must act like a proper young lady. When the narrator says, what if you saw the family's honor exposed so shamelessly out on the street? This quote is showing how the girl felt fear of bringing shame to the family if her family were to find out that she took the place of the mannequin. She may be having fun in this way because she is constantly being oppressed by the desires of her family and society. Her motivation is to be able to enjoy herself and have some fun. She does not want to be restricted by the thoughts of her family and society. However, they still haunt her when she is doing this action. The thought that some of her acquaintances might spot her here had not occurred to her until Shamea came along. This quote shows how she is scared that someone she knows will spot her. One of the more uplifting parts of this story is the way that other people looked at the girl through the glass. They always commented on how lifelike she was, and how some of them even said that she was gorgeous. This helps the girl feel appreciated, something that she had rarely felt before. This is shown in the quote, the two girls gawked at her with admiration as they exchanged a few words among themselves, while she looked at them with tenderness. She was happy, incredibly happy. No one had looked at her so appreciatively before. The quote talks about two girls who saw her standing in the glass and admired her, and how happy she felt because of this. The girl is a realistic character because, like many people in the world, she feels pressured by her parents and society. She feels the same pressure of having to always put a good appearance, putting her family's dignity before her joy, and having to act in a certain manner befitting her. I would also say that she is a dynamic character because she changes from the start to the end. At the start of the she felt unappreciated, and after seeing how people looked at her and the nice things they said about her, she had more confidence in herself. This is shown in the quote, confidently, she strode away, briskly but lightly, happy and satisfied, as though she'd unloaded the entire festering weight of her body and soul. This was said at the end of the story, showing how she changed from the start. The unnamed girl is definitely the protagonist of the story, as she is the center of everything, and it is through her thoughts that we learn about her. There is no one antagonist in the story, but the main antagonist, I would say, is a combination of family and society views on how she should present herself. Moving on to conflicts. One of the conflicts in this short story is the girl versus herself. This conflict is caused because at the start of the story, she did not have much appreciation for herself or confidence in herself. She knew that she was smart and sophisticated, but she did not know that other people appreciate her. Another conflict was between her and society. Her family also has the same views as society. Both her family and society want her to be a proper lady, and they have certain views that she must follow. Replacing the mannequin was one of the things that she would be reprimanded for if her family found out. This is also shown in the quote, what if he saw the family's honor exposed so shamelessly out on the street? Wouldn't he drop dead? This shows she thinks that her brother would actually die if he saw her behind the glass. The setting of the story is never really described besides that it occurs at the Chandir cloth store in a marketplace. One can assume that it occurs somewhere in or around India because the author was born there, and the fabric stores are selling is saris, which are common things for women to wear in India. She is said to be wearing a sari in the quote, the hem of her sari going over her head then dropping down to wrap itself around the joint of her right elbow. This probably occurs somewhere in the 20th century because the author died in 2001. The setting is important because in India there used to be many rules that indicate how women should act, and this is shown in the story as the girl feels the pressure of the views of society. One of the themes in the short story was that if one does not know how to view themselves, they turn to others' opinions to define themselves. This is certainly true in this short story, because the girl does not know how to feel about herself at the start, but near the end she has heard a lot of good things from others, and decides to be more confident in herself. The narrator says, the two girls gawked at her with admiration as they exchanged a few words among themselves. While she looked at them with tenderness, she was happy, incredibly happy. This shows how the girl feels about herself after receiving admiration from others. The diction of the story has some impact on the story. There are many descriptive words used, and this may be to show that the girl is smart and intelligent. This is shown in the quote, "But now she was a grown young woman, costumed, smart, sophisticated, and urban." This contrasts the action that she does of replacing the mannequin, something that can be seen as not proper action by a lady. Some of the sentences seem to be choppy, and this may be because it was translated to English. The mood of the story seems to be secretive and guilt. The girl feels guilt for doing something that her family would disapprove of. She also needs to keep this a secret because if her family finds out, they'll most definitely be disappointed in her, and they might even punish her. She's shown to be secretive when she says somebody might see her getting out of the show window. She'd have to be very careful and fast. She needs to make sure that nobody sees her leaving so her family does not find out. There is a symbolic meaning of the girl becoming a mannequin. The symbolic meaning is how she wants to be seen and appreciated by the people around her. She wants to be more than what society wants her to be, and doing something so improper is a sign that she is not happy with the way that society oppresses her. The point of view is third person limited omniscient, because the story is told in the third person, but we are limited to hearing the thoughts of the girl. This allows the reader to relate to her situation, how she feels behind the glass. The audience also finds out how she feels good about herself after she is complimented by the people that have walked by her. The two girls gawked at her with admiration, as if they exchanged a few words amongst themselves, while she looked at them with tenderness. She was happy, incredibly happy. This shows how she feels after she is admired by such beautiful women too. The plot structure was basic, and this allowed the reader to easily follow along with the story. There was a single climax, and that was when she saw her friend. Seeing her friend reminded her of what would happen if she was found out by someone she knew, and she exited the store shortly after. This is shown in the quote, "The thought that some of her acquaintances might spot her here had not occurred to her until Shamia came along. This was precisely the time when her older brother returned from work," she recalled with horror. This quote shows how she feared that her brother would find her doing something so shameful. One critical device in this story is the simile. No one looked at her as so appreciatively before, at least not in her presence, like a kind and caring queen receiving the adulation of her subjects. The girl is feeling admired and she compares herself to a queen. This is important because India did not really have any powerful women in that time. Another cool rhetorical device was personification. This device was used when the narrative describes how the girl's feet were hurting because she was standing for so long. Her feet again started to protest. One instance of foreshadowing was the start of the story, where the girl describes herself. She says, "Why did she do it? She probably didn't know that herself. True, she was something of a daredevil in her childhood, but now she was a grown young woman, a costume, smart, sophisticated, and urban." This is important because it sounds like something her parents would say to her if she did something bad. They would always tell her to denounce that she was a young woman and she should not be doing the type of stuff that she does. This foreshadows a conflict between her and society that becomes clear later on in the story. The title of the story informs the reader that there will be something to do with posing in the story. This is true for both meanings of posing. For one, the girl poses as a mannequin for the entire day. This is as said in the quote, "Then she opened the door of the show window and deftly removing the lovely mannequin, stood herself in the plastic dummy's place, assumed its pose." She not only poses as a mannequin, but she also assumes the pose of the mannequin. These are the citations from our work. And thank you for listening to this presentation and hope you enjoyed it.